Hey guys, Bruce, a part-time prospector here. One of the questions I got asked the other day was, what is calcrete and how do I know if I've got it on my ground out in the bush? Now, calcrete is, most of us, I think, have ever been at prospecting or even try to dig any type of hole in sort of outback Australia have encountered calcrete. Calcrete can occur in multiple forms, but generally it is this white looking rock that seems to either occur in bands, nodules, or as a cement around other types of rocks. It's very, very hard to dig, and it seems to be, in my opinion, feels like it's everywhere. But what is it? Calcrete is calcium carbonate, the same sort of composition as made up of limestone. But the difference here is limestone occurs at the bottom of the sea from seashells and other bits and pieces in the ocean. At the bottom of the ocean, that's where limestone forms, coral reefs, etc. Calcrete is a land-forming limestone. In other words, it's a terrestrial limestone, terrestrial calcium carbonate deposit. I think is its proper name. And so how does this form? Just before I start that, most of us see the calcrete as a bit of basically a pain in the bum. We get a signal in it. We try to hack it out. It's so hard. We end up using a hammer and chisel. We make a dent in it. We try for a while, and then I've seen too many people just walk away and say, I'll see if I can find another one. Okay, so it's generally treated as something to be avoided. But don't. Geologists like to look for calcrete because it can be an amplifier of the gold that's directly below it. So I'll get to that as how they use it by explaining how the calcrete actually forms. So calcrete forms when rainfall falls down onto the landform. So let me explain this a bit better. Imagine rain soaking into the soil. It picks up tiny bits of calcium and carbon dioxide as it travels. As the water moves down and evaporates or slows down, it leaves the calcium carbonate behind. Mineral rings in a tree to some extent. In dry places, the water gets pulled up through the soil by capillary action, like water on a sponge or paper towel lifting the water off the surface. As the water moves down and evaporates or slows down, it leaves the calcium carbonate behind like mineral rings in a tree to some extent. In dry places, the water gets pulled up through the soil by capillary action like water on sponge or paper towel, lifting the water off the surface. Now, as it gets near the surface, the water evaporates away and the dissolved calcium carbonate precipitates out and is left behind. This picks up all sorts of stuff in its travels down and up. Even fungi and bacteria have been known to be caught up in the calcrete. Calcrete isn't always one big solid sheet. It comes in lots of different shapes and textures called morphological types. It could occur as a powdery calcrete. This is soft and loose and generally occurs further down. Nodular calcrete, lumpy, bumpy, very, very common. Tubular calcrete, or rhyolites, is basically tube-shaped structures that form around the roots of old plants. And they can look like fossilized tree roots, and they can track down through the soil profile. Hardpan calcrete is what I was talking about before, and it seems to be everywhere, is a very hard cemented layer, commonly seen at the bottom of gullies and washaways, where you can see the calcrete is actually bound together all the broken rock. Calcrete is common in dry and semi-dry parts of the world. I'm not saying Australia, but parts of the world. It is really widespread in Australia, covering about 21% of the land mass. That's higher than most other places in the world, mostly because Australia is more arid than most other places on the earth, apart from Antarctica. It also occurs in the United States, and over there it is actually called, and I hope I get this right, caliche. So it's pretty much the same stuff, different name, different place. As I mentioned before, it can help in geologists find gold deposits. So how does this help? Calcrete is a great help in mineral exploration, especially where valuable minerals are deposited deep under lots of regolith. Basically, you can't sample through the regolith. So maybe windblown sands on top or transported soils, you can't sample on top. Elements from the buried deposit can travel up through the ground and get trapped or concentrated in the calcrete layer, which is closer to the surface. Metals dissolve in water, move up, and even tiny bits of minerals can move physically, sometimes thought by tree roots, can be brought up and fastened into the calcrete. The way gold sometimes spreads in calcrete over a buried deposit can look very much like a mushroom, by spreading outwards near the surface, and this makes the target look bigger and easier to find by using soil sampling techniques. This isn't just a theory. It has actually led to real discoveries. The most famous example is the Challenger gold deposit in South Australia, found in 1995. Its discovery was directly linked to sampling of calcrete. And this really put the whole calcrete sampling technique on the map, especially in the South Australia area. So that's our quick dive into the world of calcrete. I hope you learned something. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more geology, gold prospecting, and exploration topics. Let me know in the comments if you've ever come across calcrete, and if you've ever tried to dig your way through it, and if you'd like more content like this in the future. Thanks, guys, and see you on the next video.